This is former Indiana basketball player Brian Evans, and you're listening to Indiana Sports Beat with Jim Coyle.
Today's guest is brought to you by Reynolds Family Dentistry of Sellersburg. You need a $1 million smile for those championship photos, and that's exactly what you'll get with Reynolds Family Dentistry. Welcome back, Indiana Sports Beat, here on this Wednesday, July 15th, coming to you from the Golf Club at Eagle Point Studios, and could not be happier to welcome in Bob Kravitz. Bob, how are you, sir?
Gentlemen, I'm doing well.
Closest thing that I think we have to an investigative reporter in these parts, because last week we talked about the Oladipo piece, and man, you kind of nailed it just right on the head as that has continued to play out in this Victor Oladipo saga.
Yeah, this has been really, really odd. You know, last Wednesday he says he's going to go down to Orlando, play some 5-on-5, see how that feels, and then make a determination as to whether he's going to go forward and play. Then on Friday night, you know, news dump night, it comes out in The Athletic, and I'm glad that he talked to The Athletic, but it comes out in The Athletic that he's done, that he's not going to play. Well, then a couple of days later, now we're hearing again from The Athletic that he's considering playing. And I've got to think that there are financial implications involved there. I don't know if there was a misunderstanding or what, but, you know, he's gone back and forth. And it's whoever is in charge of his messaging, whether it's Victor himself or his agents or representatives, man, they're not doing him any good, because this is a bad look for Victor Oladipo.
Yeah, and it's been it's coming out that there's thoughts that he might be wanting to head to Miami, and then he's been so beloved in Indianapolis, obviously, because of his Indiana connections as well, and it's kind of taken a little bit of a hit.
Oh, absolutely. You know, he's, like you say, he's kind of, for the longest time, he was the anti-Paul George. Well, guess what? He may be Paul George again. We may have Victor in town for a shorter period of time than Paul George spent here. So, yeah, it's a bad look for him, and it's a shame because you know, at the same time, he's going to become a free agent, and he's got a lot of interests outside of basketball. He wants to set himself up for his post-basketball life. Music is clearly an area he wants to go to, and, you know, there are you know, better places in Indianapolis to pursue a musical career, like New York, like Los Angeles, maybe even Miami. So I don't blame him. He's got that freedom to do it, but the way he's gone about it, he's messing with the emotions of a fan base, who at this point, their only real hope for the Pacers, you know, if he plays, I think they have a chance to get to the second round, but without him, I think it'll be quick and dirty.
Yeah, and of all times, I was just talking in our last segment, Bob, me and Todd were talking about the TBT last night, how much fun it was. You know, we were kind of invested because Remy Abel and Mo Creek were former IU players, were on there and had a shot, and it was a great game and the emotions, and it was fun to have those emotions, and fans are really jonesing for that. So to for that to be on the precipice of coming back and have your main guy, the most beloved player, kind of stuck in this stuff, it's not what the fans are looking for right now, for sure.
No, I mean, we've had enough bad news around, you know, the globe for the last, whatever it is, 6 months, 7 months, you know, since mid-March, basically. And, you know, we've had really no sports news. And you think about Indianapolis, you know, Paul George wanted out. Andrew Luck walked away. Now we're dealing with this Oladipo stuff. You know, to me, it would make sense, you know, if Pacers made Oladipo available as soon as humanly possible and get him out front to really address some of these questions. Now, he may not want to. He may, you know, want to play this game, and that's fine. That's his prerogative. But there's going to be a ton of speculation until we've got some closure on this thing.
Yeah, Todd, there's, it's usually always when things go awry with a player in a city or whatever, it usually comes down to money issues. And that's kind of what we see playing out here.
And it is. And it's become, you know, I've talked about this at length about how much I, you know, why the NBA is different. I mean, we hear the players say it from the time they get there until they retire, that it becomes a business. Like, it is a business, and it's a money business decision. And I don't blame Victor for what's going on. I mean, Bob, I think you make a great point. I think his agent needs to step up and take the heat right now and say, hey, look, you know what? I misrepresented it to Vic. We didn't realize the money situation. I don't think anyone in the real world would blame Victor Oladipo for, you know, not playing if he wasn't 100% healthy and going to get paid versus if they say, hey, you know, you're 90% healthy. There is a small risk of still injury, but you're not going to get the $3 million if you don't play. I don't think I wouldn't blame him. It is a business. And
me either. And, you know, he's going into, you know, after next year, he'll be a free agent. He'll be 29 years old. This is probably his one big giant payday. He's looking at the kind of money that, you know, it generates, wealth, you know, generational wealth, basically. You know, his kids and grandkids,
right,
and extended family are taken care of for the rest of their lives. So why wouldn't you err on the side of caution? But it's the way this whole thing has been done, the way it's been handled.
Sure.
It's kind of like with LeBron, the decision. Nobody had an issue with LeBron deciding to take his talents to South Beach. It was just the way he did it. It was so clumsy, and I thought reflected poorly on LeBron.
Yeah, I agree completely with all of that. I mean, and it comes down to, this is what an agent's job is right now. I mean, this is if he wants to retain and be a part of that next big contract Vic's going to have, he's got to step up and take the bullet, even if it's, you know, maybe not completely true. He's got to step up right now and take the heat off of Vic, because it'll make his job and life a lot easier in the long run.
And Victor, I think he needs to step up as well. You know, I mean, Victor, you know, they do these daily Zoom interviews from down the bubble in Orlando. You know, if I'm Victor and all this craziness is going on, I want to be front and center and explain what in the hell is going on and why it's going on and who screwed it up. Because right now, whoever is making the call, whether it's Victor, who is a very smart, independent-minded guy, or whether it's his, you know, his people, it's hurting his brand. And I think that Victor is more and more seeing himself as not just a basketball player, but as a brand. There's nothing wrong with that. But, you know, if you're going to be a brand, you know, likability is high up on a list of priorities. And right now, he's not coming off very well. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, it seems like it's almost not impossible, but it's very difficult for a superstar to leave a market intact. It happens, but it's hard. Even for Peyton Manning, it was hard, but he's managed to do that. Reggie Miller had no problem with doing that, but it's how you leave. I mean, you mentioned Paul George. That's what leaves the taste in the mouth of the fans, and there's long-term considerations. Like you said, the generational wealth is already there, but there's when you're that popular, there's going to be many more opportunities for you, but it depends. Those opportunities are dependent on how you treat the fans on your way out.
Yeah, you know, it's weird because I think about Lance Stephenson, and the only place where Lance Stephenson has had any kind of success as a pro was in Indianapolis, and yet he keeps leaving. You know, he went to Charlotte a couple of years ago for a contract that was arguably worse than the one that he was offered by the Pacers. I'm not saying that Oladipo is going to go to New York or Miami and be a bum, but, you know, this is a place that traded for him. This is a place where he really developed and ultimately took off and became a two-time All-Star. And, you know, I'm not saying he owes them anything. He certainly does not. But, you know, sometimes, you know, be happy where you are. And, you know, does he, you know, I mean, he's got a pretty good gig here. If he feels like he can maximize it financially somewhere else, then God bless him. But, you know, if that's the case, then clearly Kevin Pritchard is going to have to make a deal so they don't lose him for nothing.
Well, and I think, Bob, your point of, you know, his career after basketball is probably a bigger, you know, it's a big issue. It's one to think about because, I mean, I don't know him that well, but I don't see Victor Oladipo retiring and living in Indianapolis or Indiana for the rest of his life when he's done playing. He's got other things he wants to do. And so to him, I do probably see this as a, you know, I think it's a job for him, and I think he loves Indiana. I think he loves the, you know, when he comes back to Assembly Hall, the fans are always going to go crazy, whether he plays for the Pacers or the Miami Heat or the New York Knicks. And so that part of it's going to be there, but I don't see him as a super tie to Indianapolis for the rest of his life. So I think we look at it and want the storybook ending because we're Hoosiers and from here, but at the end of the day, it's a business to a lot of these guys. And I think he's going to make a decision that's best for Victor Oladipo.
Yeah, and I have zero problem with that. That is his prerogative. You only get one chance at this thing, and
right.
You might as well make as much as you can and play in a place where you feel like you can develop your skills off the court, whether it's music or business or whatever it might be. But, you know, have some consistent messaging. Don't jack people sure. around. Don't jack the Pacers around. Don't jack the fans around because this is a really, really bad look for Victor Oladipo right now.
Bob, last night we got a chance to watch the TBT Championship, something fun, something that we got to be invested in. Obviously, Remy Abel and Mo Creek was on sideline cancer, former Hoosiers, but give us something to root for. It was awesome having something to root for, having those emotions. Man, oh, man, was it weird to be able to be into a game for the first time in 4 months.
I know, isn't it? It's wild. I mean, it's like when I went to IMS, I guess it was 2 weeks ago now, and heard the roar of the engines for the first time in months and months and months, and I was like almost emotional about it. You know, I was like, you know, where has this been for a long time? And yeah, you know, I mean, fandom, we all miss being fans. I mean, I gave up my fan card to some degree, you know, when I got into this business, but. Hell, I still love sitting down watching a really good hockey game and getting emotionally invested in it. And yeah, it's just part of our lives that have been missing. And it's cool to be able to see you know, Mo and Remy and all those other guys do their thing and get emotionally tethered to the outcome. It's pretty nice.
You got any with the Athletic, of course. What's coming up next for you?
A lot of golf. I'm taking the week off. So the Colts Open July 28th. We'll be doing some Pacer stuff before that, but nothing specific because right now all I'm thinking about is golf.
Sounds good, brother. I hope you hit them long and straight. We appreciate you coming on and enjoy the week. If you make it down to Bloomington, let us know. I'll sick Leary on you.
All right. That sounds like trouble.
This is Jim Coyle from Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle and Leary. Indiana Sports Beat is now a part of the Rivals Network. You can go to thehoosier.com to sign up. It's free. Catch the show there each day live or at your convenience. You can also like or follow us on Facebook, follow the show's rebroadcast, anywhere you podcast. If we're not on a radio station where you live, we should be. Let your local station know they need to carry Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle and Leary or simply go to thehoosier.com.